All right, time to take up the city, but first, a bit of foreshadowing with Mason.
Don't tell me Mason was a double agent all along.
No. Oh no, something's broken.
The young master's cup. Is something bad going to happen to him?
It's symbolic.
Yep.
Sig and I will take two men and head for the top floor. Chiton, you take the two remaining men and open the castle gate to let in our main force. If we can catch Shakan, we are sure to succeed.
Right. When you capture Shakan, give the signal. It's probably best to open the gate at that time.
Above us is the castle bailey. The keep must fall quickly. Shakan should be on the top floor.
In the room that used to be used by the young master's father. Try not to damage the castle. Avoid all needless combat, and above all, remember, speed.
That's why there are so few of us. Our objective is Shakan, so ignore the Gebler and Ave soldiers. You hear that, player? Alright, let's move on out.
Who that?
Do we get to play as the...
Hello, go ahead, Pedro.
Okay. Could this be... Were you still a child when your father, the king, passed away?
Don't remind
me. Oh, I miss those days. I am glad to see that you are still alive.
Old man, that was then, but this is now. When things calm down, I'll come back.
All right.
Here I go to save a day.
Here I come to save the day.
Do we get to play as his mentor?
Sigurd, you mean? No, he's not a playable character. Oh. It's Shakan and Yanga.
You've saved us the trouble of finding you, Shakan. Now get ready.
We've been expecting you.
What?
Shit.
Ah.
Huh.
Someone's niched. Crap, an ambush.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. Where is Carr?
I see you are quick to catch on.
Yeah, closing out, leaves.
Sure.
Then rat it out.
Ramses should be taking care of all your divided forces out by the Nissan border as we speak.
Shit.
Wow. Things are going to hell in a handbasket, and we've just started.
Ramses easily saw through your plan to use a feint attack by Kislev long ago. Don't underestimate us. Hugo, have you lived down here so long that your mind has slipped? And Sigurd, who would have thought you would have joined the last survivors of the royal dynasty?
Dynasty. Just stick with dynasty.
Damn it. Why are you still backing Shakan? What does it matter to you who the king is?
Huh. He's just the son of a murdered king, Fatima. He refused to cooperate.
Oh, it's his fault for not submitting.
He needed to get with the program or die. It's as simple as that.
Look, someone has to submit, okay?
It wasn't me.
You can all pick from straws if you want. You mean to say that now he wants to be our puppet all of a sudden?
That's the only way to be a big shot, Shiri.
I would rather not, thank you. I don't want hyperlink blocked, whatever that is. That I don't believe, even coming from the mouth of a traitor like you.
But sure, you can get it from your sweet big soul.
Sure,
I'll just take the chromer and go. Besides, stupidity in puppets has its advantages.
I'll bet. Unless you're a puppet yourself, in which case, stones and glass houses, sweetie.
She looks like she's high all the time.
Stupidity? Myung, what's that supposed to mean?
Mr. Shakan, I'll let you handle this. You must protect your own position.
Oh, goody, we get to kick his ass properly.
Unfortunately, not remember where I'm basically under fire.
If only there was something to help us.
We don't care who is sitting on the throne. Any obedient sheep would be fine.
Puppet!
However, isn't there something that you still have to do?
Get my mustache shaved off.
If you will only do that, then we'll help you as much as possible.
We'll let you be more than a puppet.
Your facial hair is distracting.
Yes, you don't have to tell me. One must take care of one's own country's criminals personally.
Then, with your permission, I shall take my leave.
I did not give you your permission.
Out of here before everything goes down crumbling. Hey now, wait a minute. You do know I'm still here, right?
Goodbye, boys.
Okay, I'm a guy.
Can't argue with that, can you? Huh. You pirate. No, you're just a sandworm. You've caused me enough shame. But this is the end. You didn't know your place, and now all that awaits you is annihilation. Prepare to fire! What?
Oh, look at that! It's the sand crab.
That Chiton brought earlier.
And it's piloted by Mason? What?
Aha!
You wretched rebel, Shakan!
Oh no!
Just as planned!
Make one move and this Gatling gun shall be spitting fire!
Oh god! Some hot bars!
Reinforcements have arrived, young master. Please come aboard.
No, don't you see, Pedro? He's gonna rap at him so much that it'll cause him to collapse.
Shall we depart?
See ya, you bald geezer. We'll settle this later. Till then, go get your head waxed.
Just fire. Fire. You have a clear shot. No.
Fire your guns, you fools.
This is not good.
For some reason we've forgotten how. For some reason we've forgotten how the guns work.
Reaction.
Is this some kind of joke?
Yes.
These can't fly after all. Just surrender. Thanks for the loss. I almost hate to have to shoot you.
Well, maybe you would hate it so much that you don't want to shoot us anymore, right?
Everyone, please get down.
Do you have a plan, Mason?
Leave it to me.
Okay.
Ooh.
Run away!
Basically.
Don't you fools!
It's a tank, sir. We can't pierce through. Mason, you're just walking in circles.
What?
Just leave it to me.
Okay.
He was just getting momentum. Whee!
So long, sucker! Ha ha!
Well, shit.
What the fuck was that? All of you are fired.
He needs a moment.
So the mission was kind of a failure on Bar's part.
Thanks for saving us, old Mason.
Please raise your head. My duty is to protect the Young Master. I'm sorry it took me so long to help you.
I feel bad you had to get involved. I appreciate it. I guess that teacup was foreboding when it smashed.
It's a trick I picked up long ago. It's nothing special. I'm no expert on it. I'm actually a bit embarrassed about it.
Young Master, the Royal Capital's armies are returning.
Well, cried.
We were the ones that took the bait. We must escape before we get caught. Head for the bridge as soon as you are, through your preparations. So yeah, again, this is your hint. Save again, please.
Well, that was a bit of a failure. Can today get any worse?
Oh.
Yes.
What do you think?
Well, we haven't still seen what Faye is doing, so hopefully he's a bit better.
Well, last we saw Faye, he managed to fend off 5 different mechs and managed to survive by the skin of his teeth against a girl mad on drugs, so...
That's the thing, he still hasn't reached the actual Kislev border yet, so...
Oh, goody. Wouldn't this be a perfect time for Grahf to then show up?
Remember, Mianga told him to stay put even if she would not intervene, so who knows exactly what Grahf wants to do.
In all these evil machinations going on, Grahf just seems to be the random guy in the background going, yes, do all your evil plans, but I'll be important later. In fact, I'll be so important that I'm gonna boom all you all to irrelevancy.
Again, it's funny. We're still 1/6 technically around, almost like a bit after that, but apparently 1/6 into it. And I can tell you, we haven't even unveiled even half of the entirety of the game.
Okay,
in any kind of game at this point, any straightforward game at this point, you will be reaching around climax territory. But again, because the game is taking its sweetest time to actually tell its story, again, things are slower pace, especially because there are so many factions and characters involved.
To give credit, I feel like this was a thing with a lot of Square Enix projects even before this one.
Like I mentioned, it's a bit more thick than what was it. I mean, Final Fantasy VII was a bit more balanced. It was starting with 8 and to an extent 10, that Square also, that Final Fantasy also started dipping into that kind of thing. Not as thick as this one. It's probably strongly implied that 12 probably would have been like this if it had its entire story realized.
It actually does kind of make me wonder, though. I think I'm starting to get a good idea of what may be going on with Faye. However, then I realized something. If Faye really was coked out on the drive here, wouldn't he have needed to have consumed it to have gone crazy like he did in the first part?
I can tell you this, Jova. You still know nothing about Faye. So...
Fair enough.
Let's wait until things happen, don't worry. Anyway, the point is that Faye is literally charging in, guns blazing, attacking literally the convoy on its own.
Okay, I guess Faye really found his new purpose in life, because I'll admit, I'm kind of...
He's actually very determined.
Fair enough. Relay to all ships! Fire at will! Begin evasive action! But don't let fire support positions collapse!
Oops, bad. Oh, it's BRB, Pedro. Yeah, and Deji too.
My aerial mind.
How many machines are on air patrol?
Alright. Aviation officer, wait.
The fuck is wrong with his face?
Crow officer, change of orders.
It's a weird tattoo.
Have the 2nd Destroyer Squadron approach the enemy flank. Open the fleet side and bait me into entering the confines of main gunfire.
My god, dude, you really want to use that gun so badly? Huh?
Hey, I can't...
That's stupid!
It really is.
There's no way the flagship guns can hit speeding gears!
Fire control, gunnery chief, ready to type 3 shells.
He really wants the honor.
And prepare to engage the Kefinsel's main cannon. I'll magnet them into pure energy.
Admiral, what are you doing pulling the anti-gear gunners back?
Quiet down, aviation officer. Thanks for your valuable opinion, but I am in charge, not you. What do you use RP shooters and 40-cent guns?
Oh, you know, precision, rapid fire?
Discussion over. Captain, not too fast. We don't want to leave the enemy behind.
This guy. Like,
Heidegger.
Sorry, Dejimon?
No.
He's like that one. He runs with that one guy.
No. Okay.
All right.
Give Heidegger credit, Dej. Heidegger was much more strategic. Could he be headstrong? Yes, but he didn't do blatantly stupid actions like this.
Now you have a small gameplay change. Faye is basically making a beeline, and you have to avoid both the gunfire and the small gears. If you touch one of them, you enter automatically into a fight. But if you get hit by one of the shells, you will lose HPs, counted for your maximum HPs.
Can you run away?
From these, no. if I recall correctly, no. You're supposed to live. Fortunately, the enemies are relatively fragile, so you're just supposed to destroy them, and they do not hit you that much. Yeah, like that. Again, there's just small troopers. The real fun begins when we actually get to the main gun.
Oh, I've fallen and I can't get up!
That's part of a plan. Still, I guess something in Sigurd and Chitna's plan worked. The fact that, Vanderkaum is as predictable as we thought.
Maybe, if Faye can win here, we can use that to turn the tide. Maybe.
Hopefully. Again, this section is a bit hard to actually manage to go through unscathed because there's so much shit fighting at you.
Mm-hmm.
Have you done it before?
Yes, and like I said, Dej, I did play this game one time before recording this. This is not a blind playthrough at all. If anything, while it's not a 100% kind of thing, I will get as much thing as I can with this, you know, including side stuff. Just because, you know, it's fun and there's it's good information to know. But the first time I did not really have that much trouble, to be honest. Again, I have to mention again, this was still, like mentioned part zero, this was the time I was more casual about this kind of thing. So at this section, I was still, you know, interested enough, but not to the point of being super engaged. And let me tell you, not the next part, but a couple of the next one will test also your patience, because the pace will really slow down. I can tell
story-wise
you this.
Story-wise or gameplay-wise?
Both. Literally both. So again, in a couple of parts, your patience will be tested on that front.
I will say, this game definitely likes to do its dips and peaks with that.
That moron hipper. Pursue them. They're just playing with him. You're not good enough to be my dog.
Our mobility is too different.
Fire control. Gunnery chief, he hasn't fired a shot yet. Range from tight trees within 500. Don't fire till you see the whites of their eyes.
Gears at battle speed can move at 2,000 out. 2,000 per hour.
This whole ship, all of you are morons!
You're the biggest moron! Black enemy gear inside units, stick to your escort!
The Weltall is not black, it's purple or blue at best.
It's a dark color.
Or gray, clearly not black. Anyway, second bit. It's
quick,
a bit
we
more
have to
easier.
Catch up to the flying battery!
Basically. Yeah, sure. Again, it's a bit more easier than the previous bit, but you still have a couple of enemies to fight potentially. There you go.
So, do you have like a particular favorite segment with like a cool mini game gameplay style or whatnot?
Later, actually. Later, don't worry, Jova. It's for a later part. I'm actually surprised we managed to include that in this game, but again, it will become clear later on.
Okay.
Look, if I just try to... There you go.
Just a little bit more.
Ouch. There. At least there are not much enemies on this bit.
Alright, dodge the escort! The ship in front of you is the Kafeinzel!
There it is.
Oh, it's gold!
Or more like brass, potentially. Fire control, gunnery chief, what are you doing? You're not even close, are you blind?
No, sir, I just wonder why you put that blue cross on your face.
Basically, the side gears are literally destroying the escort. Idiotic! Idiotic! What is this mess? Yeah, and the other guys is just leaving.
Enemy gear above! Enemy gear diving from above!
God damn it! Ramses will have my hide! And now, normally we'll adjust the boss fight here, but considering the moment is a bit cathartic, I decided to add this. Why not?
You're literally fighting the cannon head on.
Yes, it's kind of like Final Fantasy V, where you have to literally fight a hyper-sized cannon. Your trick is go directly, make a beeline for the cannon, ignore the side turret, because if the countdown reaches zero, the cannon will literally amp your health. Let it do it another time, and you're toast. So
wait. Yeah, are you that's playing a Gilva Sunner version of this?
Ah, the Silva Gunner, to be precise. It's an high quality rip using the lava level from 3D World, Mario 3D World, to recreate one of the battle themes from Evangelion.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah, it's like, wait a minute, this sounds wrong.
It gets even better, Dej. Apparently, YouTube detected it copyright-wise as that track of Evangelion. Even if it's not.
Basically, Dej, Giva Sonner is where he legit has, like, the actual soundtracks.
I know. You don't have to explain these. I just mixed the two up because it's like...
Uh-oh. Yeah, if I don't destroy it now, I'm basically boned. Again, the fight unfortunately is structured enough, and again, I didn't even to use the boost, thankfully. If you use it, you're basically good to go.
Oh yeah, got him!
Got him.
All personnel, evacuate! All personnel, evacuate! Abandon ship! Prepare to evacuate!
Just because your gun has been taken out?
Admiral, forget him! Zamon, anyway!
Right. I still have that. I still have that.
Yes. I have the thing. The thing of great importance.
Yes, I still have that. I still have that. Yes, I still have that.
If you're talking about your pride, I think that got shattered a while ago.
Unfortunately, he has something a bit more than his pride.
Oh, he has his own gear.
No, remember, he's still a man that prefers, like, big guns. So, all in a day's work.
Huh. Yeah. There you go.
Yeah, and it's all due to your support. Thanks.
Stop the border guards. We destroyed them. Well, we've done our job. I hope the others do okay.
Bart and his team. He's probably okay. Any word from them?
Nothing. They say no news is good news, I guess. My gear doesn't have a very good comm equipment. They probably did fine, though.
Uh-oh.
Don't tell me that thing can transform.
Oh, that.
What's wrong?
No. Down he goes.
I'm not sure about that, Dwibs. Oh, so he did have a gear.
It's not a simple gear, it's basically more of a tank.
Simple gear is a different anime altogether to you.
This should be fun.
I will kill Praxis! I mean you!
Well, we just took down an entire legionary submachine, so...
Oh my god, it's weapon.
Alright, basically, you are accompanying these two that allow you, that help you out, but they cannot do much damage. They're just to be bait for the boss, basically. The Dora unit, there you go. The important bit is, again, once again, to just keep pummeling him, because again, at this time you don't really have a mean to recover your gear's HP. And your fuel is a bit still, you know, a bit low compared. But now the boss can do this. He can literally grab some of your allies if it wants. If it does, if I recall correctly, he's blocked from having one of its special attacks. Again, it's been a while since his boss fight. I forgot all the details. It's a bit similar to that three-armed robot that Reno unleashes on you in Final Fantasy VII during that bit in the submarine dock, you know? Uh-huh. Otherwise, it mostly attacks just with the guns, so you need to be worried on that. But yeah, otherwise, this is basically kind of like your major final boss, because there you go, head cover broken, defense down. But if I recall correctly now, he's gonna start to unleash also the more powerful attack. Then we're actually closer to the end of the first act, actually, with the next part it would be.
In the actual game, this was like a disc or something?
No. The game still has discs on its own, but... Considering the major you know actions that are taken, the game is still divided in some kind of acts, which are very defined by when one ends and whenever one begins.
And I'm guessing that since you technically got this via digital, you know, you don't really have to worry about the discs, do you?
No, not really. Again, when it works for the PlayStation, PS1 collections, not collection, PS1 ports on the PS3, for example, or PSP, is that they come with the whole thing is digital, and pressing the select button allows you to switch discs at will, so when it requires to do you just need to press select and do that, and it will do that automatically.
Mm-hmm.
For the modern ports, like on PS4 on PC, the whole thing is just not present at all, because for convenience's sake.
Oh, so this one even has a modern port on PS4?
No, I'm talking about games like Final Fantasy IX, for example.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Still,
I'm actually curious instead, Pedro, if you know that, since I know that it was a thing on the original Xbox 360. What were the stopping points of Final Fantasy XIII when it came to the discs?
Oh no! In the Xbox One emulations, when it comes to multi-disc games, the disc swap is done automatically. You
no,
even
no,
you
know that.
He's wondering how many discs the original release of 360 had.
I was curious.
Final Fantasy 13, like I said, too, free.
Yeah, but I was curious to know if there was a defined point of when the disc stopped. You know, that the game stopped.
If we
took that advantage or something.
That's
like the same DVD.
I never played the 360 version of 13.
So. No, it's all right.
How weird must it have been though? Imagine, from what I recall, Final Fantasy X on PS2 didn't need multiple discs. So imagine having to go back to multiple discs.
Remember, it's it was because the. Original Final Fantasy XIII was supposed to be released on the PS3, but because Square Enix saw that the PS3 was becoming problematic a bit on its own, they decided to have a port on the Xbox 360. However, they did not have accounted the whole Blu-ray to DVD conversion, so they had to compress the game and pull it on multiple discs.
Not to mention the original 13 has a crap ton of FMVs in super high quality. Which is why they decreased that number so they could fit on DVDs for
thankfully,
the
like Pedro mentioned, the Xbox One version doesn't have that kind of problem.
I've got that version.
Mm-hmm.
Time to blow up.
Series S.
Do you want the power? Who are you?
the narrator.
Jova, you wanted Grahf.
There we go! Grahf sticking his nose into everyone's business.
However, Jova, it's not as easy as you can imagine. Basically, it's gonna be a bit of a recurring gimmick, but you will see in a second.
He's gonna be the tuxedo mask when it comes to bad guys.
Mm-hmm. So he's the Rita Repulsa of the game.
Kind of. I am Grahf, the seeker of power. Doth thou desire the power?
Oh, now you're just being flowery.
Also, the frame rate is tanky. The power
is yours!
I think the music is kind of tanking a little bit as well. Yes, I know that's deliberate, but...
To be fair, this is actually Grahf's theme, so which is... power! The power! I want it! I want the power!
The power of one.
No.
The movie she gave a 4.
So that's what Grahf loves to do. Just channel little energy into his fist. My fist is the divine breath. Blossom, O fallen seed, and draw upon thy hidden powers. Grant unto thee the power of the glorious Mother of Destruction.
So I guess that powers up his tank, or gives him the power?
The powers up the tank, and him both. Basically both. But we'll see the outcome of that for the last bit of Act 1 in the next part. See ya.
Pedro, see ya. If I don't hear the Power Rangers theme in the next part, I'll be disappointed.
How is Pedro's fault?
Oh, Tia. Sorry, I'm tired.
See ya.
See ya.
See ya.